Hello, my dear friends. Welcome back. We are discussing about the cells of the connective tissue. So up to here, these were the three lectures regarding the cells, the osteocyte, the osteoblast and the chondrocyte. Now we are discussing about the chondroblast cell, right? Okay, friends, welcome back. And let us use the same titles, right, and explain about the chondroblast cell. Right, friends. So, friends, I hope you are clear about the blast and the site from the previous lecture. Please watch those lectures. Once again, I will tell you that blasts are those cells which are always producing the ground substance and fibers of the tissue. But sites are those cells which have lost the capability of producing the fibers and the ground substance of the tissue. So, in the previous lecture was about the chondrocyte, and this is about chondroblast cells, right? So, these chondroblasts are the cells which are always producing the fibers and the ground substance of the cartilage, right? So again, we will discuss, we will write, they are always producing, right, fibers and ground substance of cartilage. These are the cells which are always producing fibers and ground substance of the cartilage. So they are called the chondroblasts. And what is their shape? The shape of these cells, their book have written that they have spherical shape, right? So it means that they are little bit rounded in shape, and this is their nucleus, right? And this is their cytoplasmic contents and other things. So these, they have little bit spherical shape, right, friends? Then the next important feature of these cells, we say that what is their number? So we say they are present 15,000 cells per millimeter square of this cartilage, right? So if you take a very small piece of 1 mm square of the cartilage, right, and you see that there are about 15,000 cells, 15,000 chondroblasts are present in the 1 mm of this connective tissue of this cartilage, right? Then what is their lifespan? For how many days these cells will remain? So they will remain for 25 days. For 25 days, they will produce the fibers and ground substance. Then after 25 days, they will be converted to chondrocytes, right? And they will remain in the bone. And after about 12 or 14 days, those chondrocytes will also be vanished or will die. And there are the production of new chondrocytes from these chondroblasts. Okay. They are derived from what? So again, we say that this is a connective tissue cell. So they are derived from the mesenchymes. Okay, friends. And what is the location of these chondroblasts? So in the previous lecture, I had told you that if you take a piece of the cartilage, right, and you see that in the ground substance of the cartilage, there are certain areas which are a little bit pits, right? And in these pits, these cells are found. So again, osteoblasts and osteocytes are both of them are found in the lacunae of the ground substance of this cartilage. So they are present in the lacunae again. And what is their size? So their size is about 15 to 30 micrometer. You know, in the previous lecture, I had told you about chondrocytes, that their size is about 7 to 30 micrometers. So look, the size of these blasts is a little bit larger than the size of the site cells, right? So they are 15 to 30 micrometer in their size. And what is their function? They are always produce cartilage formation. Cartilage formation. Why? Because they are producing ground substance and fibers for the tissue. So we said their function is to form the cartilage tissue. Okay, friends, this was about the chondroblast. So up to now we have covered four cells of the connective tissue: the osteocyte, osteoblast, chondrocyte and chondroblast. Next lectures will be about the next cells of the connective tissue. See you guys there.